Hello, this is Kevin again, and I'm ready to start part three of our rocket stove space heater. And this picture is for Tinny over at minibulldesign because he said he gets bored of seeing the same intro on this video every time. So this is the top of the box on the back of my motorcycle for everybody to see. I have a pack rat, and this is the top of the back of it, just for minibulldesign, and I'll make sure he knows I sent him out a pitch. Okay, on a more serious note, I cut the other end out of the tank, and this time I was very careful to cut it out with my 4.5-inch cutoff grinder so that I didn't cut through the inner lining. So this particular cap will just drop right back on there, and it should seal pretty good, because it's a taper fit. Okay, let's take a look at this tank. What we have left here is a 5-foot tube of steel. Looking down inside, you'll see that there's the old liquid tube from the propane tank. And about a foot and a half down here, we have the hole where the gauges came in, right there. And I'm going to cut that hole out of there very neatly, and that's where I'm going to weld my exhaust. So from this exhaust up, I'm going to run about 32 inches, and that'll be the top. 32 inches from here, and then from here to the bottom, which I've got all upside down right now, is where I'll put the combustion chamber. So that's what's coming on this video. I cut out that, used to be where you could have a gauge. I cut the gauge hole out and stuck in this piece of pipe. Now I'm going to weld around it, and that will give me my exhaust. This is going to be the exhaust for the entire stove. And this is the bottom. The exhaust right now is closer to the bottom and up to the top. So that's where we are. When I get done with that, we'll come back to the video. Now that I've got the exhaust welded in, I can begin to install the combustion chamber into this tank. And I'm going to leave this bottom skirt down here, or at least part of it, to use as steps, I think, to use as legs. I'm not sure about that yet, but we'll see. If it works out well, the legs will be the bottom of the tank, so it can just sit on its own self. As you can see, it leaves me somewhere between 10 inches and a foot before we get to the top of the tank. And that'll give plenty of space for the air to come up from the heated combustion and swirl around and cool down and begin to flow back down to come out here. Every now and then, guys, it's got to work. I cut the slot to put my burner in here. It's upside down. I dropped it in the hole, made my measurements, and that thing was within 1/8 of an inch of dead center at this end. So I said, that is close enough for me, and I tacked it right in there. So now all I got to do is center the pipe at the other end, but you can see looking down through here how that thing fits in this tank. It goes right up the middle. Right up here toward the top, and it stops about 10 inches from the top. So now I get that thing welded in there. We'll get some insulation on this baby, and let's see what we can find out. Once again, not real pretty, but it's welded in there now. So now you can get an idea of how the stove looks. From the side, hanging from the overhead. One of the handiest things I put in my shop, right there. Rolling hoist. I'm going to flip it upside down, notch out the bottom, and weld the bottom on it. Okay, that's all there is for tonight. I've got the combustion chamber in there and welded in. I've got the bottom cap on and tack welded. I've got the top cap sitting nicely in its hole. Now tomorrow, we'll finish it up, add my magic ingredients, fire it up maybe, and make it work. This is Kevin Bacon. Good night.